الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد السلام عليكم everybody and congratulations today. But today I've come to congratulate you on two special occasions. The first of which we know is very obvious, on completing the 30 days of Ramadan. To finish that cross line, to know that you worked so hard for 30 days to hold back what Allah has made permissible for you out of your love for Allah. That is the first blessing that is upon us today. The second great blessing, as you know, no one has recited La ilaha illallah in this house for over almost 100 years, for what we know. And we are the first Muslims in over a century to be able to pray and worship Allah in His beautiful house once again and liberate La ilaha illallah. And just as though we are a brand new community, with a new community comes more responsibilities. And so in order to understand what our main purpose is, we must not lose focus of why we are here and what is our true role in society. Because the masjid is not just a house of worship. And to help us understand what is the true purpose of being in a masjid, let's travel back in time 1400 years ago. And imagine you are among the people in Medina. And you know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is about to walk in to Yathrib, which is known as Medina now. And imagine standing shoulder to shoulder in those crowds. And you know that the Messenger of Allah, the Nabi of Allah, is coming to you. And just imagine the anticipation. What would you say? What would you think when you see the Messenger himself, sallallahu alayhi wasallam? And so when you see him, you see his beauty and you see his radiance, and you don't even have words to explain yourself what is going on. And the crowds are all gathered in front of him. And the Prophet of Allah knows that this community doesn't just have Muslims. It's a wide variety of religions in Yathrib at the time when he first came. And so what advice does he give his people? Now imagine this. This is the first advice that he's going to give to the people of Medina. The people that will liberate his name and expand Islam throughout the whole entire world. And over 2 billion Muslims 1400 years later will be reciting La ilaha illallah. And so the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first he comes in and he says, Afshu salam, tutimu ta'am wa seelu al-arham, wa sallu bil-layli wa nasu niyam, tadukhulu al-jannata bis-salam. Such beautiful and poetic words by the Messenger himself. Afshu salam, spread peace. Tutimu ta'am, feed people. Wa seelu al-arham, keep your family ties. وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٍ, and pray in the night while people are sleeping. تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِالسَّلَامِ, do this and you will enter paradise in peace. SubhanAllah. Four lines is our mission statement. The first one, أَفْشُ السَّلَامِ, spread peace. On this day, do not let anything get in the way of your happiness today. Do not let any distractions be in the way of your happiness. Be the people that the Prophet of Allah is talking about. Spread peace on this day. Make sure your family is so happy when they see you. Have the biggest smile that you have ever had on your face on this day. Be able to represent what it means to be a Muslim and a beacon of hope. Have mercy and love and happiness flow through your veins on this day. I don't care if your brother or sister got late taking a 2-hour shower in the morning and now everybody in the family is running late to Salah, right? We've all been through that. But be the people that when people look at you, that they see a sign of hope, that they see this person is peace. That is the first thing. تُطِّمُ الطَّعَامُ, and feed the people. As we know in these last 30 days, what it feels like to not have food in your stomach. Now imagine the people who have to wake up every day, parents that have to wake up every day, not knowing what's going to go in their stomach, or the food that's going to go in their children's stomach that day. Just imagine that pain. Just imagine that anxiety. and what it feels like. And we know what it feels like to work all day and not be able to eat or drink anything. But this doesn't just mean feed the needy. It says feed people. So show people that you are generous. Show your coworkers, your family on this day, bring food and enjoy food. Feed your family, feed your coworkers, feed whoever it is. Let people know what it means to be Muslim, that we are generous people. So the first thing, afshu salam, spread peace, be signs of happiness. Tutim muta'am, and feed people. Show them the generosity that a Muslim should exhibit. Wasilul arham, and keep your family ties. Now this is a tough one, keeping your family ties. Because we know as we grow older, what is the thing that happens? We become more independent and we become less reliant upon our family. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ says that if you want a community to grow, it has to start with yourself. Spread peace and be generous. That's the first two things. Then the next thing is that you gotta maintain your family ties. You gotta be good to your family. I don't care what issues you have with money, politics, whatever has angered you, does not matter. On this day, you have to call them up today and say, Assalamu alaikum. Do not be afraid, because you're not doing this for yourself. If it was not me standing up here, and if it was the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling you this, would you listen to him, yes or no? So don't be afraid. Do it for the sake of Allah and his Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's a very famous hadith in Sahih Bukhari where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he explains in the book of manners, that those who cut off their family ties, Allah has cut them off. Imagine being the people at the end of Ramadan when Allah is about to cash in all your good deeds, then one bad deed exists, and that bad deed is that you have cut off your family. And for that, you cannot reap the reward of your Ramadan. How unfortunate would that be? And you know what? This is the toughest one. Keeping the family ties, because no matter what, they're your blood and you always gotta stick together. Wasilul arham, wasallu bil layli wan nasu niyam, and during the night, pray to Allah. What does this mean? Who do you talk to at night? Who do you go to speak to for comfort? Who's that best friend? Is it your wife, your husband, your brother, your sister, your parents, whoever it is? Who is that person that you're really close to, that you speak to at night with your problems? Now the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us what? That at night, start building that relationship with Allah again. You know what it felt like these last 30 days to be close to Allah. Don't let that wither away over the next 11 months. Let this month be the reason why your iman is so great that even the angels look down upon us in jealousy. And so maintain that close relationship with Allah. I don't care if it's making a dua before you go to sleep or praying tahajjud, whatever it is. Keep that connection with Allah safe. And if we can do this, the Messenger of Allah says four things: spread peace, be generous, be good to your family, and pray in the night to Allah. And what is the reward? تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بِالسَّلَامِ. Do this and you will enter paradise peacefully, no problem at all. The difficulties of this world might be difficult, yes. But you will enter paradise peacefully on the day that people will be begging and crying for peace. And so with this, that is our main mission statement as Muslims. And if you realize, three of the four statements is what? Being good people. So on this day, be the best person you can be. It doesn't mean that you have to pray five times a day. It's okay if you miss a prayer, just always make it up. But the role that Muslims play in society as a community, now that we have been established in Parsippany, is we gotta be good. We gotta be good people, and it starts with us and our family. And then you will see, just as though a flower blooms, you will see that there will be dozens and dozens of roses and beautiful flowers that are gonna emerge from this community. And when people look at the community of Parsippany, they will be in awe. They will be in jealousy of how beautiful it is. And to end on a dua, Oh Allah, we constantly seek your assistance and we plead that you make us amongst those whose acts of worship and charity were accepted during this blessed month of Ramadan. Oh Allah, we put our trust in you, so help us achieve our goals in life and not to place a burden upon us which we cannot bear. Oh Allah, we seek your aid to liberate the Muslims from the shackles of oppression around the world and grant ease to the Muslim Ummah. And we ask of you to rid us of the coronavirus and to keep us all united, protected, and connected at all times. And help us maintain this beautiful spirit of Ramadan and give us the opportunity to witness many more. Ameen. On behalf of myself, my parents, my wife and family, and ICCC's co-founder Dr. Muhammad Ibn Ahmed and the entire management staff, we wish you all a blessed Eid Mubarak and Afshu Salam. Please go spread the peace.